The Progress Report.
What's going on? It's your girl, Lila Shepherd. Today we're doing Conversations with Lila, presented by The Progress Report. Today I'll be speaking to the producer and artist, Honorable Cino. You guys may know him for producing hits for ASAP Ferg, Gucci Mane, and many others. But today we're going to talk about his new album, Signs, and get into it. Appreciate you being here today. You know, it's very important to talk about our emotions and how we're feeling, you know, spiritually and all that good stuff.
Right.
So you just released this new project called Signs, right?
Right.
Okay, so right. Talk about that title. What does, you know, the word signs mean?
The word signs is like, you know, just going through signs to the big album that I'm producing. You know, everybody's ready for 2020. But it comes with signs, you know. It's the everything, all my emotions that's going into building up this big album. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's like everything I went through from leaving from Michigan to this point. You know, all my experiences. You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha.
100% real, you know, real shit. You know what I'm saying?
So you believe in numbers?
Yeah.
Significance of numbers.
Yeah, significance of numbers. You know what I'm saying? I've been through. I've been through stages in life where I pick up numbers through signs. You know what I'm saying? Keep going. You start seeing 11-11 everywhere.
Right.
3-3-3. Mm-hmm. You start seeing, yeah. So I've been through that before.
Okay. Any particular reason why it was only 8 songs on this body of work?
I mean, nah. It's not. You know, I know 8 is the number of completion, but no, I wouldn't know. No thing. It's like I had 40 songs, and I didn't want to give people too much at one time. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so at first it was gonna be 7, but then I did Eat, and then I like to eat so much.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I felt like, you know what I'm saying, it was like that tempo.
Mm-hmm.
I needed more of that tempo, so I threw that on there, just made it 8.
Okay.
And then, you know, some, like later on down the line, man, like especially like when you kind of like I go off of how I feel like internally, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I gotta agree with it. You know what I'm saying? I have to agree with it. And so sometimes I don't know what I do and then look back down and it's like something that means something. Like, damn.
True.
You know what I'm saying? It'll catch you. Like, damn, it just fall like that. You know what I'm saying? So
mm-hmm.
It could mean something.
Right.
But right now, it just ain't, you know what I'm saying? There's no significance right now.
Gotcha. Okay. So how are you feeling right now emotionally and spiritually?
I'm great. I feel whole. Like, you know what I'm saying? It was a shaky process to get to this point.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, now that I finally did it, I feel like, you know what I'm saying?
Because
at first it was like, nah, I ain't want to rap. I ain't want to be a producer rapper. Like, that happened for, like, at least I fought with myself for at least, like, 8 months. But it took everything in my spirit. Like, nah, you got to do this. Like, you have to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, nah, I don't want to do that. So I had that fight with myself for a minute.
I'm never gonna sell my soul, I'm never gonna stunt my pose, I'm never gonna lay down and fold, I'm never gonna bow to these niggas, I heard that stunts your growth, the pledge, never turn back on my bros, I'm good on the love of my foes, you won't catch me not on my toes, I never run out of new flows, I heard your new shit and it blows, what? Oh, they ain't gonna like this, I know, we know they don't like it, they ain't gonna like this, I know, oh, they ain't gonna like this.
Okay, so I wanna go through these 8 records with you.
Right.
You know, I want to get a better understanding of, you know, your mentality for creating these records, okay?
Yeah.
So we're going to start with number 1, The Pledge.
Well, The Pledge is, like, basically me, everything that I stand for, my morals.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? It's certain things that I feel that, you know, for money, some motherfuckers be like, fuck it. They just go out the window and they throw shit out there. But me, you know, I went through a lot of struggles and all that type of shit in my life. Just standing on my morals. Like, I ain't gonna fuck with that because I don't believe in that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I could have went that way, but I got morals that would prevent me from, you know, doing certain shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, when you're a producer and you're like, well, man, you're exposed to them. They're like, any and everything. But me coming from where I came from, my upbringing,
mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I sell dope, so you ain't gonna never see me, like, sniffing coke or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? To even get in or fit into it, like, a big, like, I won't do that. You know what I'm saying? That's just something against my will that, like, I, like, that's just, like, one of the things, like, I morally won't do. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't care what door to get through. It's just, like, some certain things, and they just, I ain't fucking with it. You know what I'm saying? I ain't knocking no nigga for doing it. You know, that's what you do, but, like, me, from what I, where I came from, I just can't, it just don't add up to me. You know what I'm saying?
Now, you know, coming from an underprivileged background, you know what I mean? I'm from the Midwest, too.
Yeah.
So I get it. Talk about unlearning things that you thought to be true.
Oh, yeah. All the tricks and the shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Thinking everybody on TV rich. And yeah, man. You know, it's, it was a hard, even things, like, spiritual things that you thought was real. Right. Or, you know what I'm saying? Things that happened to me in life that showed me it was real. It's a lot, you know what I'm saying? It's a lot having to deal with, you know, especially when you come from a negative mind, you know, a negative mindset. You know, everything is like, come from a, where everybody violent it, like where you from, or, you know what I'm saying? You was exposed to a lot of things, you know, coming up. You have to, like, rewire your mind to think a whole different way, because, like, you don't win that way. Like, you know what I'm saying? You can win with a negative mind, but it's not going to last that long. And so when you start getting around more successful people, you start seeing how they behave and things. And you're like, damn, look, you know, it's fucked up. Like, we'll be in a session and niggas playing their music. And the whole room is like, oh, this shit hard. And I'd be the only one in the room like, nah, that's some bullshit. I don't like it. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, okay, if you're in that type of environment, if you're not going to add or be conducive to that environment, why even say anything at all? Like, I had to learn myself to stop doing that, because it kind of like throw the vibe off of the whole room. And I done said plenty of things was whack, and then I went platinum, so I done learned to shut the fuck up, you know what I'm saying? And really just, you know, take things and study things for what it is, because I think it's, you know what I'm saying, a certain type of way, don't mean that's what it is, you know what I'm saying? Some people might enjoy that, but see, me coming from where I come from, I'm not able to enjoy that like that, because I'm not no dancing ass nigga like that, you know what I'm saying? But it's 900 million other people that are, so it's like, okay, nigga, learn how to shut the fuck up and, you know, study other things and, you know, be more open, you know what I'm saying? And that's where I'm at with it. It's just like, you know, being more open to things, man. Right. It's not closed, oh, I ain't doing that, you know?
Right.
Oh, I don't want to do that where I'm from. Like, that's how it was at first, but now it's like, nigga, you want to succeed, try to be more open. Like, you're a producer, you're supposed to be open. So, like, when I first got down here, I was doing nothing. Like, people would be like, do pop music. And I'm like, I ain't doing that shit. And then people like, try to do country. I ain't doing that shit. I don't do nothing but hood rap shit. And then my homeboy, I was eating noodles, man. We was starving. My homeboy got a check for like $40,000 off of one pop beat. And I was like, how you do that with them one chords again? So, you know, I just, you know, just learning, you know what I'm saying? The whole mindset of changing, you know what I'm saying? You have to change, and those are signs. And, like it's either it's part of your process. Like, coming from that situation, you have to grow into something bigger than what you were. Some people can't evolve. That's why when you go back to the hood, you get the niggas that's doing the same thing they've been doing since, you know what I'm saying? It's like, because life goes in the circles, it's a process. You know what I'm saying? So if you're not learning, you're going to stay right there until you learn. And then you get elevated. Then God keep elevating you. And so that's the thing about evolving. Some people don't evolve. And some people do. You know what I'm saying? Some animals evolve. Some animals become extinct. You want to be the animal that evolves.
Right.
And that come with even with people thinking about you. You got to learn how to deal off with that and all type of, or what you think about yourself, because the process of what you think about yourself might not be what God think of you, your God honest truth of who you really, really are. You know what I'm saying? It takes time to grow into that. You know what I'm saying?
Honorable C-Notes.
Don't forget where you came from. Don't forget what you done. I should sit down and write me a book. I'm not the two or the three, I'm the one. I should celebrate, I shook the feds. I did. Pay my taxes, I'm out of the red. I did something you ain't dead. I've been places you ain't been.
I did.
I can't cannot follow them trends. I lost my.
Speaking of trusting the process, let's talk about the second song off the project, Double It.
Yeah, Double It was the song. Double It was the first song I recorded off of this album. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Me and my homeboy Yesdy was in the studio. Mm-hmm. And it's the process of anytime I invested in myself, I doubled my money. Mm-hmm. Even when it didn't look like it. So I started off with a small machine, then I took all my money, then I invested in the machine, then I took that money, bought some work, and then for my re-up money from the work went and bought the Motif 6. And I always see my money, you know, double it. So every time I invested in something and just jumped off of faith, anything that was like on some righteous shit, it doubled. You know what I'm saying? And that's when I figured, you know, I kind of realized, you know, that's just what that is. If you talk about, you know what I'm saying, like me and God got a pact. Like when I told him, like if you help me with my music, you know what I'm saying, I'ma all the way trust you. Like you know what I'm saying, I'm not going to sell work no more. I'm not going to touch it. I'm not going to mess with it. That's what I'm going to do. And I did that, and he proved to be right. So that's why I say on that verse, as God, I stuck to the covenant. I ain't selling my soul. You know what I'm saying? You can't hustle it. They ain't giving it to us. We muscling. On my square, you would think I was, you know what I'm saying? That's like, you know what I'm saying? That's my covenant. That's my pact. I stuck with it, and it got me here. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, you know, for some niggas, it'd be hard for them to make that transition from the streets to music. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a scary jump.
It is.
It's a very scary, like, it's a, like, damn, man, like, mm-hmm. I can do it, but nigga, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you used to a certain lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And I'm here to say, as a nigga, I jumped, bro. Like, it worked. You know what I'm saying? So that was kind of like, that's what Double It is. You know what I'm saying? It, like, you know what I'm saying, the sacrifice, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, the sacrifice you make to become something bigger and mm-hmm. better. Like, you could take 10 years and you can trap your whole life and take, like, it always was like this, when the judge was giving niggas 10s and 15s, mm-hmm. it was like, okay, I could keep on going this route and I know what's gonna happen, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, eventually a nigga might get fucked up in this shit, or I could take 10, 15 years and develop my craft. And become something, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. that can help other people, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And so I took the other path, and it comes with a process. Mm-hmm. So it's nothing wrong with, you know what I'm saying, it's nothing wrong with, that's you not square if you chose, sure. you know, take a more better path than what 900 other niggas doing. You got to stick to what's good within your being, what's in yourself, mm-hmm. and you got to move. So that's...
Yeah, man, this that fat nigga jumping off the top rope flow. Now that's out of my way, let's eat. I ain't come here to play, let's eat. Michigan, USA, let's eat. You take food from my plate, I eat. My day one's with me, dog, let's eat. And in the environment, dog, gon' eat. I'm still full, you niggas don't eat. You niggas for love, I'm still on my feet. Eat. I got that rail on the beat.
Okay, so the next record, Eat. Yeah. Now, you did say in that the old you would probably fight the new you.
Yeah.
Okay, talk about that record.
Eat. That was the last song I'm recording on this album.
Hmm.
No, and what I said on that was, I envisioned the new me and the old me hired me. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That was the fight. You know what I'm mm-hmm. saying? That's the fight of being like, damn, that's just like, I'm standing on who the fuck I am.
Right.
Like, some niggas, they ain't got no problem with that, but you got a problem with something.
Mm-hmm.
My problem was a lot of things having to do with, you know, being overweight, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like 500 pounds from grinding so hard, making beats.
Mm-hmm.
So I ain't want to go back to Benton Harbor with, like, you know what I'm saying? You got to take that walk of shame when you go back to the Midwest, and niggas, oh, bitch, I knew you weren't for the make, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't for to take that walk of shame. It was like, this or nothing. Even though I had a pact with God, you be having your up and down time. You go through every emotion, like my nigga Nipsey said, like, you go through every emotion of, you know what I'm saying, will this work, won't this work for me? And it's still a, you know, a process,
right.
You know what I'm saying? It's a process into growing into something bigger. Some niggas don't even understand this shit, like, you know what I'm saying? You'll say some shit, like, some certain stuff you can't talk around people because they be looking at you like, you crazy. It scares them. And it is scary. The truth is scary. You know what I'm saying? And ignorance is bliss. Like, shit, nigga, you have fun without knowing some of the things that you have to learn in order to become greater. But once you know certain things, there's certain shit that affect you that can't affect you no more.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like fear, you understand that's not real. You understand, like, certain things you can say into the earth and into the to come back to you. So I don't talk about people no more.
Right.
That's the old me. Like, the old me will sit here and crack jokes on you and, like, I don't talk about people no more. It's just like, I don't have nothing negative to say about anything. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, that's the old me. The new me is more of a, more, you know, I watch what I say. You know what I'm saying? I watch who I listen to. I watch who I hang around because I'm going this way. And if you're still on this shit, that's not conducive to what I got going on in my head of where I'm going. So, you know what I'm saying? It's progress is growing.
All I know is pray, hustle, grind, sacrifice, get money, help my people till I see the afterlife. Just another one that grew up on red beans and rice. Another one that grew up on red beans and rice. I'm riding hella slow, I don't wanna miss the light. I've been working with what's left and now I'm trying to make it right. Just another.
The next record, Red Beans and Rice.
Yeah.
So just, you know, talking about health and especially within the black community. So talk about that record.
Red beans and rice. Like when I was going through my weight thing, and I was like almost 500 pounds, pre-diabetic, high blood pressure. The doctor was like, "Yo, if you don't take these pills, you are going to die."
Mm-hmm.
He didn't say like he tried to like slick on be on some.
Yeah.
And so one day I was laying on the couch, man. And this is what, you know, me and God like this.
Mm-hmm.
One day God had stopped my heart. He said, "You feel that?" Mm-hmm. I was like, "Yeah." He said, "Don't nothing on this earth move without my permission." I was like, damn. It kind of woke me up to like, well, damn. Well, if you like have control over everything, what do I have to fear? Especially if you like on my side like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's when, you know what I'm saying, I started. You know, things start coming in my path, like Dr. Savy. This happened before anybody was talking to him. He was on YouTube, and I was like, this is when he was living, too. And I was like, dang, like the food do kind of mess us up. And so it had me thinking of, like, the pills and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I started eating right. I stopped eating meat and stuff like that.
Right.
And I seen Walker one day, man. He lost, like, I don't know. He was fat as hell one time. And then, like, the next week, I had called him. I'm like, "Man, what the fuck is you doing, man?" And he was like, "Oh, yeah, bro, I got to put you up on." You know what I'm saying? So he put me up on it. And then I started fasting.
Mm.
And then when I started fasting, I started realizing, like, well, damn. Like, I lost, like, 20 pounds in the first 5 days of me, like, just having a water fast. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I lost, like, 20 pounds.
Remember you said you was doing it, too.
Yeah, I fast every season.
Nice.
I just got off of fast, like, you know what I'm saying? The only thing is like this, your body, you know, expanding, and, you know what I'm saying? So I'm watching me do this, and then you go down, and then you go back up, and then you go back down. But, I started fasting. So at first it started off like, well, damn, I'm a fast. And then all the weight came back. Oh, shit, let me fast again. So I did another 5 days. Then I did 14 days. And then it was like, you know what, let me see, like, my body is used to fasting, so I did another 14 days. This is within the course of 3 years, because, you know, I fast, yeah, just water,
gotcha.
No food, nothing, ever, you know what I'm saying? And so I ended up doing 40 days one summer, and then I was like, that's when I realized, like, yo, like, we really, like, on some amazing shit if you can get past the headaches and the fear of, you really have nothing to fear, because your body, like, you'll start understanding, like, your body is not you. Like, you're not your body. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Like your body leaves. When you leave here, your body stays here. But you tell your body what to do. So you can tell, like, if you tell yourself to raise your hand, you raise your hand. Your body is here to basically serve you.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So after a while, when you mentally, like, okay, nigga, we're not finna eat. Mm-hmm. Your body is gonna fall in line. Like, all right, nigga. I ain't gonna hurt it. I might cry. It's like a little kid. It's gonna cry. It's gonna go through all those emotions. But after a while, it's like, all right, shit, I'm gonna adjust. I'm gonna take some food over here. I'm gonna take some energy. And then you start, like, looking younger in the face. And then, like, you'll start understanding shit. And then you'll start, like, when it come out your mouth, you'll understand, like, the you know, the power of life is definitely in the tongue. Like, one day I was just like, you know, it'd be hard if I got a Pepsi commercial. I was on my fast. The scent came in 3 months later. Mm. And I was like, dang, like, we really, like, powerful. Like if we stop, like, if we don't get sidetracked by what's going on, mm. it's a reason why we getting, like, sidetracked. Don't nobody want you to know who you really are or mm. how much power you really got. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, it's so much uncovered, and that's when I'm like, you know, we really don't know shit. Like, and I don't care about how many books you read, bro. If you don't really sit there and study yourself and make yourself, you don't know nothing. Mm-hmm. You don't know yourself. Everything you need to learn was right there inside of yourself. Right there. Mm-hmm. Like, right there in your face. It's, you know what I'm saying? So, things like that happen. Or, you know, I'll be sitting down, my eyes closed, and I'm looking at the ceiling fan with my eyes closed. Like, that had me, like, bugged out. You know what I'm saying? I was like, man, what is this? So, like, every year I grow and I see something different. And so when I went to Milan, you know, I'm still on this, you know, not eating bread, not following Dr. Saban. So I go to Milan, and they food is nasty to me. And it's like, yo, why is they food so nasty to me? Like, you know, I thought my taste buds was used to, like, eating the vegetables over here, but it becomes even more weird because when you go over there, they don't eat the same. Like, of course, you know, I'm not eating cheese and stuff by now because when I eat cheese, it fold me up now. Yeah. Like, after my third fast, I was over with cheese. Like, my body reject food. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what's going to happen to you. After you fast, your body going to start naturally rejecting stuff. Like, nah, I don't want that. Mm-hmm. Or it's going to make you sick. You know what I'm saying? That's what it was doing to me. So I just stopped eating anything that makes me sick. Like, I brush my teeth with Colgate and start getting sores in my mouth from the fluoride. So I had to switch my toothpaste. You know what I'm saying? Like, your body is going to start, like, rejecting stuff that's not good for it. Because you are all the way, you all the way clean from it. So, you know what I'm saying? When I went over there, I started eating croissants. That's the only thing I liked. And I was like, man, I'm going to eat this. Fuck it. I'm going to just have to work the weight off. Mm. And I went over there and I ate nothing but croissants for, like, maybe 4 or 5 days. Mm. I'm thinking I'm finna, like, be fat as hell when I come back. I lost 10 pounds. How did I do that? So that's when I figured out, I was like, oh man, we kind of slick pawns over here. Like, you know, they put a lot of ingredients in our food that don't need to be, you know what I'm saying? When I went to Africa, they don't even have refrigerators. They go up every day to their market and they go buy meat and they go buy what they gonna cook for that night. Mm. Everything fresh. They might be poor, but they happy. You know what I'm saying? Playing soccer with cans. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, man, you know, we tapped in by the hoopla. So that's what red beans and rice was. You know what I'm saying? My homeboy Dion had, you know, he had the beat in the hook in his verse. And I was like, man, that's hard, man. Let me get this. And that's, like, my spirit just took over. It took me over that way. Like, that's why I felt on the beat. And so that's why I went with it.
Speaking of Dr. CB, his daughters just opened up CB's daughters down in Buckhead, actually.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they just opened up. They had, like, a soft lunch this past weekend.
Really? Did you go?
Yep.
It, was it nice?
Yeah, it was nice. You know, it's on, like, a strip where it's other, like, wellness buildings and centers. So, it's, yeah, it's cool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Check it out.
So I know you kind of gave a brief backstory during the DJ's meeting. So I do remember you saying that he's best friends with Stevie Wonder, right?
Yep. He grew up with Stevie Wonder.
So yeah, talk about
both
that.
Of them blind.
Right.
Both of them with the blind school. He won't sign, seal, deliver a bunch of other things with Stevie. And you know, he been in the game for a long time. You know what I'm saying? And he just happened to be my uncle. When I was a kid, the only time I ever seen a limo, he had a driver. His driver was his wife. She drove the with his girl. You know what I'm saying? But she drove the limo everywhere for him. You know what I'm saying? They drove to the hood. That's the first time we was in a limo. So I was like, damn, man, I want to be rich like Uncle Lee. And so, you know, we didn't really, like, stay connected during that time, but just that one impression, you know what I'm saying, made me realize, like, dang, you can be what you wanted to be. And I knew I wanted to make music. I was, like, when I was 7, 8 years old, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, damn, like, I got to do music. That's what I'm going to do. That's what I want to do. I don't care about nothing else. That's what's happening for me. And that's, you know, off of that. And so, as I got older and I started making, like, records, that came around, he was like, yo, I heard you doing, you know, good stuff out here. I'm like, yeah, I'm doing the bid. But it still didn't happen. So my grandma told, his mother turned 100, which is my, you know, great-grandma. She turned, like, 101 years old. And then for her, for a party, we linked up. And that was our first time we went to the studio. We did that. I played that beat. And he went in there and dog the whole studio. He just blacked out on it. Like, he was just blacking out. Like, I was, like, the whole studio, you felt like these chill bumps on your, like, everywhere. I'm like, man, yeah, bro, like, he don't have a box when he write. He just, like, you know how we write, we'll be like, you know, well, this for the girls, or this for the, you know what I'm saying? Right. Or, you know, this for the hood, or this one. Mm-hmm. He don't have a box. Like, whatever comes to his mind, it's just like, you gotta have it. And so, he came with that, the wind is a blowing, and all our disguises are blown away. And it's like, damn, like, it just take you somewhere else. Like, everything you think you are, and everything you, as you get older, every disguise that you put on yourself to protect yourself from this world, blown away. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you were a kid, you totally free. You, if you goofy, you goofy. If you, you know what I'm saying, you that. But as you get older, you know what I'm saying, things, you be your goofy self, and you get around other kids, and they don't like it because of their surroundings. So they knock you for being who you are. You know what I'm saying? So that, bam, that's a disguise. And then as you get older, you get, you see somebody get money, and you know what I'm saying, you want to get money too. And so it might be against what you're doing, but you know, this going to get you what you really want. Bam, that's another disguise. Oh shit, I got to come and I got to be a certain type of way. I got to flex these certain type of jewels. Got to get this certain type of watch. Bam, that's another disguise. Like, you, as you grow older, you put these things, you add these things onto yourself. Right. If you took all these things away, what are you? Like, honestly, like, if you honestly sat down and, like, everything that I don't really need, like, want, what are my core values? How do I really feel about things? And sometimes we have so much stuff over, it's kind of hard to get back to that point. But that's where it comes with that fighting with yourself. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's that inner war. You know what I'm saying? The things that you know is right versus the things that you have become accustomed to or attached to. You know what I'm saying? So I had to do that. I had to do that. That as a, I didn't want to rap on it.
Right,
I just wanted to leave it just like that. Yeah, I wanted to paint a picture around it, and so it's perfect for, like, on my album. You're always gonna get an instrumental from me. I'm a producer too. You know what I'm saying? So you're always gonna get a cinematic production from me. You know what I'm saying? That's something that you can look forward to. My album, it's always gonna be something that, like, you can open up a movie to on there, because that's what I like to do. I always like to do that. When I play them type of beats with rappers, and niggas like, yo, man, you should score a movie. So it's just like, I'm going to do that. So, yeah, that's how that came about.
Got you. Now, going back off of, you know, adding instrumentals to the albums, speak about, you know, you said earlier that you battled with, you know, being an artist and actually telling yourself that, no, I need to do this. So why was it important for you to make that transition? Like, because I know Sunny Digital is another collaborator that you work with a lot, and he does the same thing where he does the production, but he's also an artist. But why was it important for you to, you know, not limit yourself to just being a producer?
My story different. The things I went through different, man. And plus my inside of being, like, you are not your body, you know what I'm saying? If your spirit telling you to do something, that's what you kind of like. You kind of like be beefing, like, with, like, God give you his spirit and he wants you to go a certain type of way. That's who you be beefing with for real. That's who you're, it's a flesh and spirit type of thing. Like, my flesh is worried about, man, you can't, man, you done did beats for this long, and now you want me to rap? Like, and then your spirit is like, nah, nigga, go this way. And he's like, man, I don't want to go that way. And you wake up every day and it's like, go this way. And you're like, nah, I don't want to go that way. And every day it's like, go this way, nigga. And you're like, nah, fuck that shit. And then he's like, finally, you know what I'm saying, get you to a point where everything's just, you in conflict with yourself. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And it's like one of them got to give, and your spirit ain't going to give up on you. You know what I'm saying? Your flesh is something that you can train. So it's just like, all right, fuck it. Let me fast for 30 days to get all the way. So before I started recording the last part of this album, I fasted for 30 days, from December to January. I did the first 15 on social media. I was telling people, you know, I'm fasting. I'm showing people, you know, different things. And I was smoking weed heavy when I fast. After that fast, I didn't want to smoke no more. Hmm. Like, you start getting rid of, like, stuff because you just elevate. You know what I'm saying? You understand the difference. Like, when you're down here, you get attacked by depression, anxiety, all these type of spirits. You know, they call them whatever they call them, but those are spirits. When you fast, you elevate past that to the point where they can't even reach you. It's like so it's two different type of highs you got. You got the world high, where you got drugs, shit that come, but it's a trick because it comes with depression, it comes with anxiety, it comes with anger, it comes with all these things, and then you got your higher level self high, like it comes with fasting, it comes with what you say start coming to existence, self assuredness. Knowing what you're doing, knowing who you are, knowing what you're going for, your intuition heightened 900 times. A motherfucker come in the room and they don't be for you, and you already know it. You can see things down the line. Like, it's two different type of highs. One of them is like down here, and one of them is like up here. You know what I'm saying? If I start doing a lot of smoking, a lot of fucking, then I come back down to like to hear, and I get, like, you can hear those voices and those noises in your head again. I know when the time to fast. All right, you gotta get off of there and come back. You know what I'm saying?
Gotcha. Where your grind at? Where your heart at? Where the love at? Do you love it? I ain't begging for no handouts, nigga. What's that?
Man, that's fighting with myself. Handouts going. I ain't begging for no handouts, nigga. Fuck that. Like, if you like my music, if you hear like anger and like certain, you can hear anger in certain type of beats. And then with my voice, I can use it as an instrument too. Like, that's like what I'm going for. Like, if I'm, you know what I'm saying, I feel like certain people that come from urban backgrounds, right? You know what I'm saying? We're negative minded. You tend to see a lot of people cry about a lot of shit. Like Trump, for example. Oh, you should do this, or the government don't care about us, or it's like, you, like, nigga, you have, do you not know you have the power to change all that shit, you yourself? But if you're stuck into the hoopla, which I call it distractions, you stuck into that shit, you're going to be drawn into that. You know what I'm saying? I'm the type of nigga that, like, if my back against the wall, I'm going to come out swinging. I'm going to come out fighting. Like, I'm going to come over it. You know what I'm saying? And that's me, like, saying, hey, my nigga, like, let's stop begging for shit and asking for shit and get together and start coming up with real solutions to come and better ourselves, even as a community. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, my nigga, like, the other day I had took, sometimes I go to the projects, take some kids with me, and, you know, I'd be like, I take them to go see Big Houses, because they used to motivate me as a kid, right? And then they seen the Indians that, you know, that run the store, they seen them walking out the house. I'm like, oh, that's their house? Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, you bought that for them. Mm-hmm. That's your money. Now, if you figure out how to keep the money inside, you can live like that too. Mm-hmm. But all that jealousy and hating against each other, or wanting to, you know what I'm saying? We're going to have to figure out how to totally eliminate that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And to become something greater. So basically, is my stance on being different from with the norm, you know what I'm saying? In a crowd of people, you'll see Sino standing by himself over here thinking. I'm always thinking, you know what I'm saying? I'm always thinking, like, I'm not thinking about bitches or money or none of that shit. I'm thinking about evolution. How can we evolve? How can we, what new businesses that I can open? I got 4. I need 10. You know what I'm saying? I have 4 that's running and making money, but I need 10. I need to show that. I don't need to show $1 million. I need to show 1 million hustles. You know what I'm saying? Outside of the hustle that's going to get you locked up or outside of the, you know what I'm saying? That's what I want to show. That's what I want my music to show. That's what I want my movement to show. I want my movement to show like, damn, these niggas done figured out something that that money can't buy. You know what I'm saying? It takes pride, it takes nuts, and it takes more of things. Anybody can rob, steal, and kill. You know what I'm saying? That's the easy way out. But who gonna put they self together and come with some shit that's gonna be like, you know what I'm saying? Okay, I can have kids now. I don't have any kids. Why I don't got no kids? I'm scared for them in this type of world. You know what I'm saying? It's like, nigga, y'all don't see what's going on? Y'all don't see the slaves in Libya? Y'all don't see what they doing to niggas over there? You think that's not in your backyard, nigga? You don't see what's happening to the people over in Mexico? They putting in concentration camps? You don't think that's not in your backyard? Oh, you just think it's not going to happen. What happened to the motherfuckers with them Nazis and all that shit? You know what I'm saying? Just, it might not happen. But I'm just saying, it's cool to be prepared for that type of shit. Or kind of like, you know what I'm saying? Okay, let's stop fucking around. Let's figure out.
At least aware.
Let's figure out a way to where we can self-sustain. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If not, you know, be happy with the way things that are. And I'm saying for the niggas that hustle, we the hustlers of this generation. Our story not over. We got to figure out a way to push forward. You know what I'm saying? Push the community forward. Let the young cats have their fun. But my raps is for niggas that's ready to evolve. You know what I'm saying? I'm not knocking nobody for doing what they do. Have your fun, fam. But I ain't gonna be here when you get up out of that. You know what I'm saying? Because it's gonna be a time when you have to evolve past the way that you're thinking. So, of course, when we was they age, we did what they did.
Oh, yeah.
They had fun. So now we grown. It's just like I wanted to make music and soundtrack for niggas that's going through what I'm going through. So I'm gonna be 100% authentic to who I am. You know what I'm saying? The things that I'm doing. I mean, I'm a producer, so I'm going to have some hard beats to do it over. You know what I'm saying? So.
Honorable Cena.
I am hella blunt. I do what I want. And you're just a friend. That's not what she wants. I am hella blunt. I say what I want. I do just what I want. And that is what she wants.
Okay, let's talk about I Want, number 7.
I gotta talk my shit, man. That's all. I do what I want. And it's the truth. It's the truth. Like, when you fast and you, like, when you own a certain type of level, I'm not even gonna lie, man. It's slick unfair. It's not even fair. Like, I go to the airport 10 minutes before my flight and never miss my flight. not 10 minutes, but about 20 minutes.
Okay, gotcha.
It'd be some like.
That's still impressive, though.
You know what I'm saying? It'd be like some, like, right. things that don't supposed to happen for me. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it's just like, you know what I'm saying? You just understand there's two type of kingdoms on this earth. It's what you... Like, your mind and where you at is really, it really matters. But I can't teach you how to get there if you have no faith in yourself. Mm-hmm. You have the power to get there, but I can lead you to the water. I can tell you what to do, but it's something that your faith and you have to, you know what I'm saying, work on. Like, everybody should be at war with themselves. Because all of us have fears and things that we have to knock off of us in order to get to the next level. Jesus was walking on water. You have the same ability. How do you get there? You only can get promoted by God. God can only promote you to that. That's your promoter. So the reason why you're going through the same things level, because you're not getting promoted. You're getting the same test, and you're failing your same test. You know what I'm saying? And so when you start passing your test, you see more. You see more. You get more. You know what I'm saying? So a nigga might have millions of dollars, but are you really happy? You know what I'm saying? You can't buy that. You can't buy peace. You can't buy, you know what I'm saying? So,
How would you define the word progress?
Evolve. Period. Progress is evolving. Is, you know, seeing growth. You know what I'm saying? A caterpillar probably don't know he's gonna be a butterfly. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. A motherfucker just crawling, think he's gonna be on the ground, and get caught up in a cocoon, come out with wings. Oh shit, nigga, I'm flying in the. You know what I'm saying? You evolving. Into something beautiful. That's something ugly involving into something that's like, I don't know where I'm going to be. Mm. I tell a motherfucker like, shit, like, appreciate me at this level now, because next year I might be something totally different. You know what I'm saying? I'm okay with changing. Most niggas like, I never change.
Oh, yeah.
That used to be my mentality. Not no more. I'm okay with change. Growth. It takes change to grow. You know what I'm saying? And it's not easy to grow. Mm. Growth is painful. It's painful growing, but you have, every person not going to go through it. Every person going to go through that, but you're going to back off, but, you know, some people go through that shit. I'm the type of nigga that just go through my shit. I'm going to just go through it, you know what I'm saying? Whatever you is, you is. You was, before the world was evolved, God knew who you was. You was already, like, knew who you was. So if I tell a motherfucker, if I'm chilling with a female and I be on some freaky shit, you better enjoy that shit right now, because next year I might not be on no shit. I might be on some totally, I don't do that anymore. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, yeah, I know I be talking that talk, but nigga, if I'm still on that shit, you better enjoy it, because next year or in a month or 2 months, I might not be on that shit no more. You know what I'm saying? I might have elevated past that process. It's a we all go in the process. You don't just grow at one time. You know what I'm saying? You don't just let everything go at once. It's a process you go through. And it's really baby steps. Mm. But if you go through it at your own, like, your own walk. You know what I'm saying?
Honorable C-Notes. I used to think that when I made that money, I'd be happy. Sitting here thinking of ways, huh, nigga? Get his money with his family. Can't be a dumb nigga and carry a ship when you got a tugboat. And niggas taking pieces of that shit when your eyes closed to build their own boat. And now we all gotta seek.
Final record, Bring Me Down.
Yeah. That was the record I was going through, man. It's kind of like, you know, what do they call that, man? When you make it and you like you want to help people. They have a name for it, man. Is it winners something? I heard French Montana say it one time, man. You kind of feel bad, like you can't help everybody. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And I just wanted to write a song of why you can't help everybody. Can't be a dumb nigga and carry a ship when you got a tugboat. Mm. And niggas taking pieces of the shit when your eyes closed. To build their own boat. And now we all got to sink because some niggas want to be assholes. You rather take away than add on. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, you want to help everybody, but their mind is not 100% in to win. You rather tear some shit down so you can be the man. And it's just like, until you evolve as a person or your thoughts evolve, you really can't help nothing like that, because it's gonna hurt you in the end. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you want to help everybody, but you gotta help yourself first. You gotta evolve to a certain point. You know, like, there's so many stories, man, we read of NBA players, NFL players. You know what I'm saying? They get on and they have, oh, I gotta take care of my mama. I gotta my cousin. I gotta pay, and then they become sustainable to this lifestyle of like, well, damn, you know what I'm saying? You taking care of everybody. Now, this nigga had $300 million. Where did that $300 million go? You back fucked up. You know what I'm saying? And so, with my money, I invest business with people. Now I don't have to give you no money because I invested with you. So, the first, like, my brother's a felon. He, you know what I'm saying? He convicted armed robbery. No, like, it was illegal for him to step foot on to get an application. So he was fucked up for a minute. He can't go back to selling dope or heroin or none of that bullshit. You throwing your life away. So when I got my first $10,000 check, I went and bought him a business. I said, listen, bro, this is a, you know what I'm saying, a detailing, like, take this car and flip it to three other trucks, you know what I'm saying? And instead of just giving you money, now I'm teaching you how to get money another way. You know what I'm saying? Me and my dad got another business, you know what I'm saying? I got houses. It's like, that's why I say I have four businesses and I'm running it with people in my family. Instead of giving them money, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to break the curse of, we're trying to build generational wealth. So you're breaking the curse of me giving you money and then when all my money gone, we all fucked up. No, we finna build this shit and we gonna have, you know what I'm saying, things going on, but you gotta work for it. All that lazy nigga shit out the door. Like, I'm showing you how to, you know, to get this shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, like, you can't let that bring you down because it will. It'll tear you apart. Like, you having money and you watching other people, like, around you, like, damn, man, I gotta feed my team. I gotta come up with a way. Well, if I ain't selling dope, if I promise God I ain't selling dope no more or nothing, how can I go about doing it? You know what I'm saying? So, that's something I fasted and prayed on. And I came up with that. It was just like, okay, help niggas get businesses. And now I'm giving you your own lane to, you know what I'm saying, to eat. I'm giving you your own lane to eat. You like to drive buses, I'm going to invest in something that you like to do anyway. You know what I'm saying? Now, whether it triple up, that's on you. But I did what I was supposed to do.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Respect. I like that a lot. I definitely, you know, respect that idea. For yeah. Sure. But this concludes, you know, today's therapy session. So I definitely appreciate your time.
100.
All right. Well, it's the progress for your girl, Lila Shepherd.
Oh, yeah. Some red beans and rice. All I know is pray, hustle, grind, sacrifice. Get money, help my people till I see the afterlife. Just another one that grew up on red beans and rice. Another one that grew up on red beans and rice. I'm riding hella slow, I don't wanna miss the light. I've been working with what's left and now I'm trying to make it right. Just another one that grew up on red beans and rice. Another one that grew up on red beans and rice. You gon' eat your cornbread, collard greens, candy yams, taste sweet like Halloween, a wire rose. If you get lucky with that chicken dinner, you just might get...